Next, the third type of level of we call it is the ecological diversity. Ecological diversity means it is the higher level of the diversity at a higher level. The diversity at higher level, that means we call ecological ecosystem level. Okay, that's we call it is the ecological diversity. Ecological diversity means the diversity at higher levels of organization. That means ecosystem level. So the such a ecosystem level we call this ecological diversity. Already ecosystem means you know this. Suppose pond is one ecosystem. Okay, so in India, suppose particularly you can see in India having main deserts are present. Desert is the one ecosystem. Okay, rainforests are one ecosystem. Okay, and mangroves. Already you learn in first year, mangroves and coral reef and wetlands and estuaries and also alpine meadows. So these are the different kinds of it is the ecosystems. So higher levels of organization. So deserts, we know that desert have they have different kinds of it is organism, that is called it is a one ecosystem. And as for rainforest is also one ecosystem, have social so different plants and animals, everything are present. Mangroves, the marshy saline areas, that's what we call it. In that area they are living in different kinds of organisms. And coral reefs, underwater ecosystem, that means coral reefs means it is the underwater ecosystem. Wetlands, estuaries, what is meant by here estuaries? Here the estuaries means, so this the normal water and also sea water, they are present in an area, that we call it is estuaries. And alpine meadows. Alpine meadows means a dense mat like grasses are present. Very shiny grasses. Okay, here the very small, dense and thick, shiny grasses. Dense carpet like. How it is the carpet is present? Like these grasses are like the present. It is a dense carpet like grasses are present. That's an ecosystem we call it is alpine meadows. Okay, so these are here in India has a that in India has deserts, rainforests, mangroves, coral reefs, wetlands, estuaries. Alpine meadows are greater than that of it is the Scandinavian country of Norway. So in when compared to India, other country, you can say this Norway. So very low level of it is a bio, that means ecosystem diversity present. In India having it is the greatest. In India you can say the greatest eco diversity. That means in particular it is ecosystem diversity present. So this, all the ecosystems are it can be formed, that it is a biomes. So there are different kinds of biomes, it can be formed the biosphere. So this is the ecological diversity. Once again, see, so the ecological diversity means the diversity at the higher levels of organization, that means ecosystem level. Thus we call it is ecological diversity. In India has the deserts, rainforest, mangroves, coral reefs, wetlands, estuaries, alpine meadows, greater than that of Scandinavian country of Norway. So this is the ecological diversity.
Next.
There are three indices of biodiversity. Here, in this, the indices of biodiversity. This indices of biodiversity, here three types. There are three types of ecological diversity. Okay, three types of indices of ecological diversity. Biodiversity means a particular biodiversity is all which only is ecological. So that's why the indices of ecological diversity three types. So in this ecological diversity, first one it is the alpha diversity. Alpha diversity. Second one beta diversity. Third one it is the gamma diversity. Okay, here there are three types ecological diversity. Three types are present: alpha diversity, second one is a beta diversity, third one is a gamma diversity. So here alpha diversity. In the alpha diversity means the number of the different types of species present in an area. Already biodiversity means what is a two different types of definitions I said. The variation of life at various levels. That's the biological organization that we call it is a biodiversity. A variety of number such as it is a plants, animal, microbes are present in a habitat. In an habitat that we call it is a biodiversity. That means a variety number and variation of life. You also call it is biodiversity. So the diversity within the community, actually we call here the diversity of organisms within the same community. Here see, the diversity in the same community, the variation within the same community we call it is alpha diversity. Next, beta diversity means the diversity between the adjacent the variation you can say two different ecosystems. That means the adjacent ecosystem. Here what are you supposing? This is a pond ecosystem maybe. Here it may be a river ecosystem. So and also here main is a forest. It's a forest. Forest is one ecosystem. And forest inside is a maybe forest inside some of the ponds may present. Yeah, that means here two different adjacent ecosystem between the variation we call it is a beta diversity. That is here same community set. Here the different community or maybe different community, two different ecosystem, two different communities, such a variation we call it is a beta diversity. And gamma diversity means the diversity within the entire geographical region. So that's we call entire geographical means what is present. There are different kinds of ecosystems. Not only the two different ecosystems in entire, it is the ecosystem. Entire geographical means on the earth the formation of there are different kinds of ecosystems. There are the variation you can see, the diversity you can see all the ecosystems. That means entire geographical area. So alpha diversity means here the variation, the diversity you can see entire geographical area. That means covering the several ecosystems. Okay, so here such a diversity is more stable also it may be. Okay, so this is the three different types of it is the diversity in the ecology. Okay, the ecological diversity. They are indices, means they are index of eco diversity. That the three levels of it is ecological diversity, alpha diversity, beta diversity, gamma diversity. Alpha diversity means the diversity within the same community. So in the same community having so much variations are present. That's why we call it is alpha diversity. So that means So one more definition, a variety. To count a variety of number of species in an area, that is also called is alpha diversity. Here one more definition, what is said, the diversity between the two adjacent ecosystems, that's why we call it is beta diversity. Here two different ecosystems, you can say to count different kinds of it is the plants, animals, so much of microbes also maybe, that's we call it is a beta diversity. So alpha diversity means it is the entire, the diversity, you can say the entire geographical region. So different kinds of it is ecosystem, different kinds of it is the populations are present. That's we call it is alpha diversity. Okay, so this is the three different types of it is the ecological diversities. Next, next we are going to discuss another topic. Next concept, number of species on the earth. So number of species on the earth. So how many species are present on the earth? And ask India also. So they find the some of the ecologists. Man find to believe there are nearly it is the, and I said here 20,000 species of ants are present, and 3 lakhs species of beetles are present. Relaxed species of beetles and 28,000 species of fishes and 20,000 species of it is orchid plants are present. Okay, present on the earth. Man find to believe here 20,000 species of ants and 3 lakh species of beetles and 28,000 species of fishes and 20,000 species of orchids are present on the earth. Next, according to the IUCN, IUCN means very important, so it is an abbreviation, main IUCN means it is an international Union of Conservation International Union for Conservation of Natural and natural resources. So IUCN means International Union for Conservation of Natural and Natural Resources. Okay, so this International Union for Conservation of Natural Resources estimated the total number of plants and animals is so far is no more than 1.5 million species. Okay, so IUCN, what is meant by here this IUCN? This International Union for Conservation of Natural and Natural Resources. So what are the this organization, it is estimated the total number of species on the earth. So nowadays, how many species are disappear? How many species are threatened? And how many species are great risk is going on? So everything that data is collected is IUCN and published in the book, that's we call it is a red data book. That book we call it is the red data book. Here the book we call it is the red data book. In this book there are how many total number of species nowadays, there are how many species are disappear, everything is published in the book what? Okay, and then so IUCN, once again say the IUCN, it is International Union for Conservation of Natural and Natural Resources, is estimated the total number of plants and animal species is no more than this 1.5 million. Okay, 1.5 million. Next, due to the project species 2000 and global species diversity, main here the global biodiversity information the project species 2000, the global biodiversity information, they said the new species is beginning to be discovered. Okay, the new species is beginning to be discovered. Next, actually on the earth, so many taxonomic groups are present, particularly in the temperate regions than tropical regions. Actually on the earth you can see, yeah, this is the earth, this is the equator region, these are plain, that means it is a plain latitudes, yeah, the low latitudes region. So this is the up to here, this region we call it is the tropical region, and this is the, what is this one, this is the temperate region, this is also temperate region, and also this is the Arctic and Antarctic regions. So in this regions you can see, actually here the temperate regions of the scientists, they said the species inventorious. Species inventorious means, so the scientists who are the species have discovered, those persons, the species inventorious, they said, so the temperate region actually is a more number of species are present than it is a tropics, tropical region. Actually tropical region only have, it is the more biodiversity is present, that means the distribution of species are more. Why? Because the sunlight is directly transferred into a tropical region, the sunlight is directly transferred into a tropical region, that means here see, this is the sunlight, the sunlight is directly transferred into a tropical region, not a temperate region, not that much of mainly you can say the temperate regions, temperate countries also. So whenever the sunlight is directly, they are present in that, they are transferred into the tropical region, what are the living organisms are present, those living organisms, that means plants, animals and human beings, their potential inbreed, their population it can be increases. So that's why the tropical region having, you can see the main greatest biodiversity present when compared to temperate countries. Okay, so now here one more, all the biologists are gathered, the statistically comparison they done. So all the biologists gathered, the statistical comparison they observed, particularly in the tropical and also temperate regions. How? First of all, the scientists have gathered the information for all the insects. All the insects in the tropical and temperate regions. So here all the insects information, what are, how much of species are present, the information totally gathered. Later gather the information, it is plants and animals. So all together means these insects and plants and animals all together, estimated the gross. So first the insects, the all the biologists are gathered, the statistical comparison of this tropical and temperate region. So how they are completed their estimation, particularly the first all the balls they gathered insects information. After that they are gathering information on the plants and animals. So these plants and animals and insects, so all together estimated the gross of living organisms on the earth, estimated the organism, how many species are distributed on the earth, they have estimated the gross. Okay, according to the Robert Mays, the global species diversity, according to the Robert Mays, the global species estimates, here nearly it is the 7 million species. Okay, how much? It is the 7 million species are estimated. In the Earth, biodiversity present is, in the Earth biodiversity now, that means particularly present days, how it is estimated means particularly it is all the nearly about it is so more than 70% of species regarded as animals. More than 70% of species are regarded as animals, and no more than 22% of plants. Understood? So present is in the species, in the biodiversity, in the total it is a biodiversity estimates, present is here the all the scientists, ecologists are gathered, what is the information means, here the 70% of the species regarded as animals of the total. It is no more than it is the 22% of the plants. Among the animals, insects are the most taxonomic rich. Insects are the most taxonomic rich in that all the population. Okay, so among the animals, here insects are the most species rich taxonomic group, and making up no more is more than 70% of their total. That means out of 10 animals, 7 are the insects, remaining 3 are the other species. Once again, see here animals. In the animals, total it is estimated it is the 70% of species is regarded as animals, and no more than it is 22% of the plants. Among the animals, insects are the most taxonomic group. That means nearly it is a 70% of it is insects are regarded of their total. So in the 70% means out of it is 10 animals, 7 are the insects, remaining 3 are the other species. That's it. Okay, so next, fungi. The fungi, the distribution is more than amphibians. Vertebrates. Okay, the fungi biodiversity is greater than that of vertebrates. Vertebrates means what is this? Fishes and also amphibians, birds, reptiles, mammals. So these are the very less when compared to fungi. Okay, once again see, so the fungi is more biodiversity than vertebrates. Okay, that's it. Next, in India we can see later. First of all, here see the global biodiversity, and here the first the total on the planet Earth nearly about it is a man find to believe it is a 20,000 species of ants and 3 lakh species of beetles and 28,000 fishes and also 20,000 species of orchids are present on the Earth. So the project species 2000, the global biodiversity information, so they said the new species being to be discovered. So and also next in that all the biologists are gathered, what they find means it is the statistical comparison of the tropical and also temperate regions. First they are gathered the information of all the insects. After that the gather the information plants and animals all together come up estimated the graphs of the biodiversity on the app. So according to the Robert Mays, here the global species diversity is 7 million. So total it is on the Earth present days. In the biodiversity, the present days, how many species means they are estimated. So nearly 70% of species is regarded as animals. And they are 70% of it is regarded as a species is as animals. This is no more than 20% of the plants. In among the animals, here the insects are the most taxonomic group. Is nearly they find 70% of the total. That means here out of 10 animals, 7 are the insects, remaining 3 species are present. And also the fungi have is the greatest biodiversity on the Earth than vertebrates. Vertebrate means it is the fishes and amphibians, reptiles, birds, mammals, all this. Okay, that's it. Next, in India, how it is present?